USA wins. A record third World Cup title.
The final score, 5-2. Carly Lloyd was considered the most valuable player.
Hat-trick for Lloyd!
This doesn't feel real. It hasn't sunk in.
It is called the beautiful game by those who cover it day in and day out. And on this day, there is nothing more beautiful than the World Cup trophy being held aloft by the United States. Memories of Brandi Chastain ripping off her jersey and exulting on a Rose Bowl field in 1999 are now forever joined by the first half onslaught her modern counterparts unleashed on Japan in the Sunday final. No greater final game domination in the history of the sport. Our guest is a veteran broadcast journalist who has been following the 2014 Women's World Cup for Arise TV. Welcome Jack Rico to Midpoint. Come on, Jack, even you didn't expect what happened in those first 3 minutes.
Absolutely not. I mean, they were going in as the underdogs with the defending champs in Japan, who had beat them in penalties the World Cup previously to this. So, you know, Jill Ellis had her work cut out for her, not expecting, you know, this team to really put the pummeling, as many people would say, of what happened to Japan in the first 16 minutes of the game. That has to be a record almost anywhere.
But you have to look, too, at what happened, because it would seem right from the outset the American women were much more physical, they were much more driven. I mean, to call them an underdog, I think, in this case, really didn't do justice to what they had done getting to that final throughout the tournament.
Right. If you analyze the first couple of games, that wasn't the U.S. at all. And then it wasn't until they got into the really big games where they had to really exert their effort, all their skills, you know, up to that point, they sort of just welcomed the pressure. They embraced it. They wanted the big stage. They wanted the revenge on Japan. And it showed. I mean, look, once you start looking at the U.S. team and you look at the Japanese team, just on physical play, they were a much superior team than Japan was. I mean, you were looking at Sawa, who was the 10 for Japan. She was the oldest player there, clocking in almost at 40 years old. And when you start looking at the other players of the U.S., even though about 5 or 6 of them are over the age of 30, that team is young, they're vivacious, and they really wanted this. So the result sort of symbolizes the effort and the energy that they really put into this game.
I only got about 40, 45 seconds left here. Should we stop worrying about what this means to women's professional soccer and just enjoy it for what it is?
Absolutely. I think anytime everybody starts comparing, well, you know, should the female soccer team go against the men's soccer team? That has nothing to do with it. You know, America is based on just one country alone. Everybody just was watching this game. 15.2 rating, more than any male or female World Cup game seen in TV here in the United States. And that just really says something about, you know, the league for the women's is basically new, and we should see a lot of interest in that sport and expansion of those teams. And hopefully, you know, this means just a general interest in soccer moving forward, men or female.
Let's just do that. Let's just enjoy it for what it is, because it is the world championship, no matter how to put it. Jack, thanks so much for joining us, my friend. We'll talk again.
Thank you.
All right, let's go ahead and on the end of the 4th of July holiday, take a minute, relax, and enjoy what it is. Rock on, true believers. See you tomorrow.
Valioso vino para Lloyd, gol. Gol.
Played in short.